Dating Around is a reality dating show where each episode follows one person going on 5 blind dates and eventually picking the one suitor they like the most to go on a second date with. The first season took place in Brooklyn, New York, while the newly released second season moves to New Orleans. If you're wondering how they make it, you're in the right place. From how they choose the daters to how they film it, and what really happens after the cameras stop rolling, here's everything you need to know about the making of Dating Around. The person going on the 5 dates is referred to as the lead dater. Each series has 6 episodes, so that's 6 lead daters and 30 first dates.
Wow, that's amazing.
Both season 1 and 2 take place in bustling, diverse cities, and the casting is a reflection of that. We see daters from a vast range of different races, different sexualities, different lines of work, and different interests.
Oh, so you hunt?
I do.
I'm, like, animal obsessed.
When it came to casting, the lead daters were chosen first, and each of their 5 dates were subsequently chosen by our matchmaking producers. In order to achieve the authenticity that the show does, it's integral that it features ordinary people, like you and me, which means someone's got to go on a hunt to find them. Some of the casting process was literally just putting up flyers and seeing who they'd attract. But most of the daters were found by scrolling through Instagram. It wasn't necessarily the people with lots of followers who were picked, but those who seemed interesting. And they had to be single, obviously.
Why the hell are you single?
I hate that question.
Once they were selected, the lead daters were asked what kinds of people they're usually interested in. But that only helped with the matchmaking to a point. The producers were keen to pair the daters with people who weren't necessarily their usual type. The thinking was, so often we swipe left because of some deal breaker we have in our heads, but if you actually met that person in real life, you might click and not care about that one thing. In fact, that's generally what happened with the pairs on the show. Daters constantly told producers they hated a certain quality in a person, only to go on a date and fall for, you guessed it, someone they would have normally not even considered.
Communication is key.
Yeah.
Producers would often make their predictions about who the final pairings would be, and almost every time, they were wrong. That's what's so interesting about dating. You never know what could happen. While the series is edited to look seamlessly like 5 concurrent dates, each date actually takes place on a different day. The lead dater eats at the same restaurant and wears the same outfit each time, meaning they have to give their clothes to the producers to be washed at the end of each date. Dates all take place at night, so they have to wait for the sun to set. The crew then need time to set up, which can mean the dates can take as long as 5 hours. Not great if they hate each other.
I'm over this.
Good, please.
If you're thinking, wow, the 4th and 5th date of the week must be grueling for the lead dater, you're probably right. But a lot of the time, the last date ended up being chosen for the second date. When you know, you know. The daters are kept apart until the first moment we see them meet, so their first reactions are totally genuine.
Hello.
Hi.
They're even kept apart while producers set up second or third locations, so that every aspect of the first date can be captured on camera. What you see is exactly how it happens. Once the date kicks off, the daters are left to their own devices. They can talk about what they want, do what they want, with no interruptions from producers. Daters can order drinks, even if it means they get a little too drunk. Sounds like a standard date to me.
All right, I'll cheers to that.
Hope you're not a serial killer.
There's a really small crew filming, and they stay well back. Even when the crew so desperately wants to jump in to help fill in awkward silence, they never do. Those awkward silences can be just as telling as the conversations themselves.
Let's change topic here.
There have been times when the lead dater has asked producers for their advice on who to pick or their thoughts on the date. It doesn't work. Producers always stay stumm. You might notice that the series has a cinematic feel to it. And yes, this was completely intentional. The directors who worked on Dating Around come from film backgrounds and generally haven't worked on reality TV much at all. Unlike most reality shows where the cameras move to follow its stars around, Dating Around is much simpler. It features two people sitting still and eating a meal. The fact that it's shot in static means the crew have a lot more room to play with lighting. That's why the show has an elevated and intimate look. It's supposed to capture the very special feeling of being on a first date. The lead dater is always asked to pick one person for a second on-camera date, but that doesn't mean they never speak to the others again. When the nights are over, the daters often exchange numbers. From that point on, it's up to them if they want to keep speaking. Whether it's texting with one person or multiple people, they're free to follow their heart's desire. Player's gonna play. So, there you go, some gossip from behind the camera. For more behind-the-scenes secrets about your favourite Netflix show, like and subscribe to Netflix UK.